So how the coreboot image layout may look like with VBoot. So basically there are many combinations of CBFS and flash map layouts with VBoot, and there are actually three main ones. You can have only a read-only part of CBFS, which is also equivalent to a standard coreboot build, and you can have a read-only partition with one read-write partition or with two read-write partitions. So each of these partitions, read-only and read-write, should contain at least one CBFS partition inside. So VBoot enforces this specific layout via the flash map. The read-only part is typically called recovery, and the read-write are updatable firmware. So it works like this, that each of these partitions contain a copies of the executable stages that are necessary to proceed from the boot block and first stage. So okay, let's start with at the beginning of the boot process, which starts with the boot block and reset vector from read-only part, always, because this is the part that lies at the top of the flash part, which is mapped at under the 4 GB. So here we start with the boot block in the read-only part, which then handles over the control to the first stage, which is responsible for verifying the read-write parts of the firmware. So basically, the VBoot logic in the first stage checks for the VBlock A and VBlock B. First in the order is the slot A, and checks whether the signatures in the VBlock A match the hashes and signatures in the VBlock A matches the ones calculated from the firmware main A partition containing the CBFS. And it does the verification. And if the verification passes, the slot A is marked as good, and the first stage hands over the control to the ROM stage part in this partition. If the slot A is not valid and the verification of the signature and hash failed, the VBoot logic will try the partition B and perform the similar operation as with VBlock A, and try to verify this firmware main B partition. If it succeeds, the first stage will pass the control to the ROM stage in partition B, and ROM stage will continue to subsequent stages. At the end, of course, we have some kind of payload, as well as in the partition A and B, which then loads the target operating system. However, if either slot B, or if neither slot A nor slot B is good, then the first stage will hand over to the ROM stage in the read-only part and mark that a recovery is needed. So it will mark the recovery request and reboot the platform. After the reboot, the boot block will also be launched from the read-only part, then go to the first stage. And the VBoot logic in first stage, when it detects the recovery, it directly passes the control to the ROM stage and read-only part. So then the ROM stage launches subsequent stages, like RAM stage and payload. And then the final payload in read-only part may launch some recovery operating system. It must be noted that the recovery part in the read-only partition is not protected by any signature, so this code is executed unconditionally.